Thank you, Lauren. And it was this picture posted on social media of a Pine-Richland homecoming proposal that sparked outrage and backlash. And tonight, families in that school district came to the school board meeting to express their frustrations.
Yeah, they're calling for harsher punishment for the student involved. And Channel 11's Serafina James was at tonight's meeting. She joins us live now. And Serafina, did they say what the consequences were?
David and Lisa, the school board would not address the consequences for that student, although parents passionately spoke out and said they wanted to see that student suspended. And this was the first time they spoke to the board since that photo has started circulating on social media. And tonight, parents, they did not hold back. Like I said, they expressed their disgust following that Pine-Richland student's homecoming proposal that went viral. And take a look. The sign says, quote, "If I was black, I would be picking cotton, but I'm white, so I'm picking you for homecoming," end quote. During tonight's school board meeting, the board condemned the proposal, but district parents said that's not enough, claiming the district has failed their children.
"So you have a responsibility to our community, black and brown, and any other family in the district to do the right thing, have the policies in place, so we don't have to come back and have the same conversations with you again and again."
This district is not only failing our black and brown kids, we're failing everyone. We're failing every single kid. We need DE&I. We need policies to educate our kids on how to be anti-racist.
Many parents say the district needs to revisit its DEI policy. And you may remember the district was working to create a diversity, equity, and inclusion policy known as Policy 832. Its intent was to better support and protect the district's black and brown and marginalized students, along with hiring more of a diverse faculty. But earlier this year, it was ultimately scrapped by the board. Tonight, the board made a commitment to go to DEI training when they announced that those frustrated parents you see in the video, they stood up and gave them a standing ovation. The board also says they have on the books an upcoming work session. That's a DEI work session they are planning to attend later this month. As for the student in question, again, they wouldn't discuss disciplinary action, but the board did say that the offensive act the student committed happened off of school property. Live in Allegheny County tonight, Serafina James, Channel 11 News.
All right, Serafina.